Hello everyone at Tasoni. Big hello from Paris with a beautiful unpolluted sky. I think it goes so far back that I actually don't really remember in precision. All my very early memories are about fabric moving, long dresses, women in beautiful gowns and men in beautiful attire that I would see in movies or operas or in pictures in a book. Actually, what I was obsessed by was, at a very, very early age, was the double pictures in a dictionary depicting the evolution of fashion with all the main trends, but going through centuries. So I really remember this page, and I really remember like Versailles and then the new look and all these eras were depicted on this page. But also strong memories were when I was a young teenager, I was watching Style with Elsa Clench on CNN, and I would discover much about what's going on in fashion, and I would also get to know new designers. And like, I remember discovering Veronique Leroy or Galliano on this program, so Dolce & Gabbana. And, so yeah, that's kind of my memories. I think I would ask Sir David Attenborough to spend the day with me and talk about what he experienced through all his trips throughout the earth and his vision. So that would be a very amazing and precious time and a great moment, I think. Actually, it's hard to say. I conceive, I create, I draw, I make shapes just out of the blue. I'm looking for a sensation and emotion through what I design, and I obviously am curious and interested to experience and see things all the time, and probably it nourish and gives like good soul to my designs and my creation. But I love everything, from nature to traveling to seeing people having emotions, and that fuels my design. I'd say there are several things. Once I decide to do a collection, we have absolutely silence around me, no music, and I was curious to see what had happened and what I would create without any medias that are modern and anything. And it was kind of interesting because I did a collection that was very 19th century. And this was at Rochas. It was the winter 05 and summer 06. And another source of inspiration that was interesting was, like, I got obsessed by an art brut artist. Her name was Aloïse Corbaz, and I got obsessed with her world, and it inspired me. I took no references from her work directly in my own collection, except like putting flowers around the girls and having these figures on this chest and this bust, the way you can see in her work. But it was just like an energy that fueled and gave me inspiration. Two options, or it's absolutely a designer piece, and I'm part of that. I'm part of the designers who work for quality, ideas, honesty, authenticity, creation, design, inspiration. And so that is a designer piece, let's say. And obviously a good investment is also to buy a beautiful, well-made product from a famous house like a Birkin bag. I reconnect, as always, when I'm on my own for a while with music that I was listening when I was a teenager. And so I reconnected with Mylène Farmer with L'Horloge, which is an album that obsessed me. And right now it's great because with Spotify, I just add all the all the songs that I like together, and I made like a new album just for me. And I've been listening to this like hundreds of times.